That was pretty good. You can always want to do that, but I'll tell you, maybe it would happen more at any time.
You know what, there's nobody wants to hear two people pick up and then you got in the trip of a lifetime.
Sure.
That's one thing that I feel like. So we always try to make it
yep.
So yeah, it's pretty good. There are times, you know, middle of the season, end of the season, but it gets short, it gets square.
I was getting frustrated.
So I'm going to make one more recommendation to you guys right now. When you come back and set that hook with enough oomph to where when you do hit that fish, he's going to be there. You know what I mean? And every time you come back, I want you to do it just where you know if you hit one, he's coming back. You know what I mean? You don't need to swing for the fence, but you definitely, you guys don't bump. get a line drive. Because we're touching some fish, we're just not sealing the deal.
But that's about it.
Gotcha.
Yeah. Gotcha. Unless somebody was in dire need of assistance, I don't think it happened. The one guy had a fire in his camp like 4 or 5 years ago. Two or three went over to help him. And they got there like getting up 2 in the morning, 3 in the morning, and his son was actually beside walking from behind a building with a freaking lighter. And so they think it was a little arsenic. And so then they're like, why are we here?
Takes up heat.
You know, there's one guy, he reminds me a lot like you. You know, I mean, and I don't know if you're handy with motors and stuff like
I'm
that.
I'm not.
But this guy built a whole cabin by himself.
Okay, gotcha.
I mean, this guy knows how to
build
a
log in the cabin.
Well, one guy over the boat, actually he's 571, he was having a different way, and he said, oh, you like walleye fish, you need to go to this lake. And he goes, no, yeah, so he went from 72 then to that lake. And they were like, and he came back and he said, you want to leave it?
And from what province is that?
Ontario. But it's straight north of International Falls, Minnesota. So you're closer to Winnipeg than you would be. You're 24 hours from Toronto.
See how many you get.
Let them fight. Hey, let them go. Let that rod down. Let that drag work. You guys, once you hook them, don't try to force them in. Hook them, rod to butt.
That's what we're doing.
Just hook them, rod to butt. Guys, let them go. Let them do their thing. Let them bury that hook in them. And then, yeah, check to see if you have a scale. Look like you did on your hook. See that right on the tip? Yeah, guys, hook them, hit them hard, and then let them bury that. When they take off, if you guys are pulling back just as hard as they take off,
fish are being real good.
A lot of times. Here we go. Yeah.
There goes this, don't you?
Yeah, it popped off right as you said that. I planned my trip for if it rained every day, and if it didn't, well, that's a bonus.
prepare for the worst, hope for the best.
Right? Yeah. You end up a lot less miserable that way. Thank you.
heavy for a couple of people to measure and get in the air cap. That would be
oh, he caught me way over there. I think so. Yeah, and he's running right at me. Ah, and he snapped it off. Damn it. Here's a little red anyway.
Here we go. New hook experiment. Let's try that, guys. Anyone got a sharp green hook?
Does it look huge, Jared?
What?
Does it look huge?
Oh, yeah.
Make sure you take the picture with the one that Steve got.
There one is.
You got one later?
Ah! Fucker. What the hell?
Check your drag.
Yeah, nothing's changed. I don't know why they're not staying on all of a sudden. tried muscling them, then I just tried letting them come in, and neither one's working.
At least you're hooking. I was about to say, guys, shit, sometimes when you fish, crazy things happen. You know, I don't know. You guys aren't the first people to do anything
wrong. Hey, it ain't my first fish I've lost.
I've seen from behind us, they've stepped up tight along the grass line. And then right out in front of me right here. Right here between us and that boat.
Yeah, it's getting pretty active behind us again.
Where's the next hot spot?
I still need a couple more.
Yeah.
Okay.
What's going on?
I do not know. But let's keep going. Let's not stop.
There you go, get that one.
Take your time.
Go ahead.
because it'll get bent a lot. Tighten it so it don't come out.
Careful, my line's right there in front of you.
Good looking color. Just when I like her.
I'll take it.
I like it. Nice fish, brother.
Fish.
It's a good one.
Nope, not in yet. Okay.
Thank you, brother. This one's going to be up to you. Little on the smaller side, the color's okay.
That's too small.
Keep going then. Keep what happens here.
Okay. I don't give a shit.
Good job, brother. I retained half of what you taught me. There it is.
I didn't lose
it.
No,
he didn't lose it. It was too small.
Well, why don't you ever take your class on a field trip?
Yeah, give me a second. Did not mean to put orders on your boots. I'm so sorry, dude.
All right.
Wherever that rod floated, remember, right? Yep. Slingshot coming back at you. 15 miles an hour, following the ball. With the braid, it's not as bad as the mono, but man, with that mono, those hooks come out and the rod loaded like that. That's what I'm claiming.
All right, we got two on.
So we can take our choice.
There you go. Let's do it. We'll put them both in the net and we'll examine them both. Except I already know which one I want.
There it is.
One more, just lift up and reel down.
Huh?
I ain't, my name's not Steve.
Okay.
That was worth it for the last fish. Good fight.
How do you know it's the last fish? Is the
for me.
Oh, little fires.
Heel.
I'm on my way.
Oh, well, that was fun.
That tail, didn't I?
Yes, you did. That's why we're going to let him go. Been attacked by something there.
Oh, yeah.
All right, gentlemen.
You guys can carry your way.
But look at this one.
Sorry, fish.
Look at the one my man Ty got up top.
Nice. All right.
Fish.
That's what we're talking about.
Yep.
Right there. Good job, Ty.
It's a carp.
So do you damage their air sac when you do that?
So you guys, their gills, you rape one while the heart's going, it's an artery. It'll pump all that blood out of
you. Blows them out?
Yes, correct.
I've seen you do it with each one.